Hey y'all, Faith Kelly and Kazu Moon here, and we are currently sitting under a tiki, and we are toasting today to our executive producer and one of our best friends ever, Clown Daddy. Clown Daddy, we love you and we wish you were here. Oops, your drink is holding up the phone right now. We love you and we wish you were here. And
you would have really liked today.
Well, Clown Daddy had given us some tour instructions before we left. She said to have fun. And today we went to one of our favorite beaches.
Playa Linda
Beach. And we had fun, man.
The shit beat out of us by some waves.
I feel like I had to exercise. It's the Atlantic Ocean is so much different than the like Tampa Bay waves, where it's like you can kind of just like swim around and float. There's no floating in this ocean, man. Like this is like a battle. You go there to practice battling.
Yeah.
But Playa Linda Beach is technically, I think it's close to Apollo National Park. So you have to obtain like a national parks pass. It's on the Space Coast. So right now I think we're at a really cool place called
The Insane Burrito.
Diego's Insane Burritos. We are currently driving down to Stewart to play our show tomorrow at East Ocean Pub that we booked with Dead Dreams Booking, and can't wait to see all of our friends there tomorrow.
Yeah, we're going to spend a little time with Michael tomorrow night after the show.
Yeah, and it'll be Gracie and Sarah and Johan, and I can't wait to meet our new friends, Miss Q, and man, it's just going to be a great freaking show.
Yep.
Man, this is great. There's a palm tree right here, just in case you're wondering. Palm trees and cacti are like two of the most amazing
palm
things.
Palm trees and cacti.
To a girl who grew up with maple trees, man. I love my maples, don't get me wrong. But yeah, today we spent at Playa Linda Beach per order of the Clown Daddy. And man, I hope we can all go there together. It is... Yeah.
When Clown Daddy tells you to have fun, you fucking have fun.
You have fun. So today we went out, and because, you know, yesterday had a little bit of not fun moments, so we said, you know what, let's go have some freaking fun. And we jumped in some waves, and
did a little body surfing.
It's a clothing optional beach, so, you know, for people who are into being a naturalist, it's just basically like being a lizard on a beach.
Yep.
That's how it feel like.
Lizards.
Yeah, just like it's just really cool to be free. So thank you, Clown Daddy, for everything. Speaking of Clown Daddy, y'all, we just got word today. So April 1st, April Fool's Day, is going to be our first technical day back home. It's actually still involved on the tour. Our first week back home, we have included on this tour just because it doesn't stop. Yeah, it's Catskill Sandwich. We're always on tour, even when
I love a good Catskill Sandwich.
Yeah, I wonder if they made what would that have in it?
Oh.
Wait, think about it for a second. Yeah. Because Clown Daddy has informed us that she's going to come to the Catskill Brewery open mic on April Fool's Day.
There's going to be tomfoolery.
There's going to be some tomfoolery at the Catskill Brewery, so you're not going to want to miss it. There's going to be...
There's going to be shenanigans.
I think... there's a monarch butterfly over there. But yeah, so there's going to be some shenanigans, and it's April Fool's, and...
Lolly Bombs are going to be there.
The Lolly Bombs are coming through. That'll technically be their first Catskill.
Yeah, it'll be the first place the Lolly Bombs have ever played in the Catskills.
Yeah, so come on out, have a devil's path with us. It's going to be really nice to see our homies, and we'd love for you guys to meet our other homies, our road homies.
Our road homies. Our LA homies, Michael and Julia.
You know, it's weird, I know
they're... Where are they at right now?
Oklahoma.
Oh, Oklahoma, yeah.
It's kind of cool seeing them do their thing, because it's like now we have something to watch.
it was kind of cool too seeing Michael and Julia in that picture in front of the old classic Lips picture.
Yeah,
that was cool.
It's there's a lot of magic going on.
Michael looks exactly the same. He hasn't changed a bit.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah, it's man, I can't wait to see you guys and give you a hug and a squeeze and introduce you to our Catskill homies and also see our Catskill homies.
Be safe on the road, guys, you know?
Yeah. Just drink water.
Yep. And stay hydrated.
If you get tired, like Chikula said, Oh, hold on, I'll be right back.
Yeah, Chikula Smith, he gave us some good information. He said, you know, when you start getting tired on the road, just pull into a rest area, walk around your car 10, 12 times, get the blood pumping. He said then you're good for another half hour or so. Whoa, look at that thing.
Sorry, it's for Clown Daddy.
Look at that.
Yeah,
at that,
so what happened is we were driving around and we were like, man, after playing in the waves all day.
This is where we ate. I don't know if you can see it.
You can see, yeah. So this place is called Dakine Diego's Dakine. Insane Dakine. Burritos.
It's a Hawaiian thing. You know, Simon probably tell us what Dakine means.
This is chorizo. That was fun.
That's chorizo?
So
it's plant-based chorizo.
We were driving down the way and we're like, man, really hungry. What are we in the mood for? And I was like, a burrito would be cool. And we are on the A1A highway, which if you're ever driving through Florida, it's worth the extra to take this highway instead of going down 95 if you have time to kill.
There's places where things can be super pricey, but we found this Dakine Diego's Insane Burritos. And man, look at that.
Well, I saw a thing that said Insane Burritos, and I said, turn around. Because you know me, guys. I love my burritos. And whoa. Holy shit. Mm. So yeah, that one you have the... Holy crap. I mean, Insane Burrito, this is going to feed me probably until we get to the show tomorrow. All right, let's see how it goes. Holy shit. This is an insane burrito. Let's try this. Mm-hmm.
How much guacamole is in that puppy?
Well, totally worth it. Also, I just want to say, guys, well, I'm sorry. When I make weird little cuts in the video, sometimes I'm just taking out some ands and ums, and there's no vital information. It's literally just I'm trying to keep the videos under 15 minutes, so I'm not missing anything. Wow, this is so freaking good. Or like two times.
Occasional nip slip.
Well, it depends on the situation. So, whoa, this is crazy. I do want to give you guys a little tour of this place. This is exactly what we're looking for. And man.
Yeah, Faith Kelly said she wanted some Mexican food
under
a tiki.
And this was it.
And here it is.
And they're playing good music, and there's stickers everywhere.
We're playing some Pearl Jam, Alice in Chains. When we walked in, the Foo Fighters were playing.
Yeah,
and right up, right up our alley, man.
Yeah, so that's, so good day.
Simon, what does Dakine mean? Because I know that's Hawaiian. I just don't know I'm not sure what it means.
So, I have a conflict, Kasmin. Speaking of Clown Daddy. Clown Daddy, I don't know if you guys knew this, but, is running for president, from what I hear. And there's some really good options running for president this year. You have Clown Daddy and you have 20-Foot Neon Jesus. And
well, what I'm hoping is that the winner...
I don't know who to vote for.
Well, whoever wins that election, Clown Daddy or 20-Foot Neon Jesus, I'm hoping that they'll pick the other for the VP.
That'd be sick.
Yeah. So let's say Clown Daddy wins by a landslide. She got 20-Foot Neon Jesus as her bit. How cool would that be? All the bitches and hoes would be saved. There'd be
laughter everywhere.
There'd be smoke in every pipe and drink in every
Y'all
cup.
Need to check. If you guys want to just get some quality entertainment, please follow Clown Daddy and also follow 20-Foot Neon Jesus. They are both good friends of ours. And Clown Daddy also has
Both running for president.
Check out her website. She did a really amazing one-man play about a year ago now, a little under, called Fool. This is my favorite play I've ever seen, and it was so meaningful and so funny, and you felt all the emotions, and she's one of the best performers I've ever seen. When I run an event, I always have her there to help, like a festival, like when we did the Martinville Ranch Festival.
You can count on Clown Daddy.
She will come in, and she will entertain the people when you need her.
Remember that skit she did with just the broom?
Oh, my God.
All she had was a broom for a prop. And it was one of the best routines I've seen.
She also, I missed it the other week, but she did a clowning workshop, which I really hope, Ellie, I hope you do another one of those, because I want to take it. We had work that night. So I'm going to show y'all a little bit of this place, and we are probably going to drive off to Pilot or truck stop.
I'm going
to
grab a couple napkins.
Get our bearings together for the evening, and hoping Monday we can find a little open mic or something. just because, like we said yesterday, it's you get when gigs cancel, it's kind of like rock and roll blue balls, and just definitely down to play somewhere and share some music with some friends, make some new friends. So really looking forward to tomorrow and getting down to East Ocean Pub and seeing everyone down there. And then Tuesday at the Connex, it's turned into a benefit show for a friend. More information on that very soon. And then Wednesday, we're going to hightail it up to Winston-Salem. We're going to meet up with the Bliss Boys and the Lollibombs. And then Thursday, we're at the Art Barn at Chad's house. Friday, Spaz Fest. Saturday, Sagebird. And then Sunday, we are home. So that will be this tour. We are booking another one, and more on that later. So yeah, check this place out. Love y'all. Oh yes, there is a lizard here. Oh, there he goes. All right, y'all. Here it is. So we drive by on this here road. This is a A1A, really cool scenic road. The beach is right over there. And we saw that, I said Insane Burritos. We gotta check it out. So I saw the Tiki Hut, I saw Insane Burritos, and I had to check it out. So yeah, man, every time I come to a place and there's a whole lot of stickers and there's Insane Burritos, I'm down. The price is pretty freaking amazing for a like 5-portion burrito. Got a little inside sitting area. Really cool. You order your burrito and you can take it for here to go. Oh, yes, this is the right way. Down through here, got really cool restrooms. I'm not gonna bring you in there. You'll have to come here to check them out yourself, but there's art everywhere. It's just awesome. So I just wanted to show you the place. So you get your burrito, you can get it for here to go. We got ours for here. Here's Kazwin. There's the, I'm taking mine to go at this point. He's, you kind of made yours a disaster salad. But it has a really nice backyard out here too. Really, really cool spot. very grateful we stumbled on this place because it is some much needed nourishment. And I can't tell you enough how fresh and refreshing these veggies are in here. For a giant burrito,
I'm telling you, I already ate all the veggie-based chorizo, but...
And the guacamole, man. So freaking good. But it wasn't like for being such a giant burrito, it wasn't as heavy as you would think it would be.
Very healthy burrito.
Very, very healthy.
There's no grease in it, man.
So yeah, amazing place. I will highly recommend this place if you're driving down the A1A. As you can see, it was such a messy burrito. I had to put my hair up and to tackle it because it's not often I do this. But when you're faced with a burrito like that, but man, it's not greasy. The food is fantastic. You can see them making it. And the people here are really cool and nice too. So I am really grateful that we found this place, and it was definitely needed after yesterday, because when we went to Bucky's, they didn't have my veggie burritos, so you know, I guess they didn't have them at like 1 a.m. when we rolled up last night. So this is the comeback burrito, and it was, you know what, it was an insane burrito. Anyway, and y'all, if you do like these silly little videos and this journey, just a reminder, whether you're watching this on Instagram, there's a little bug on there. I think it was a lizard. Instagram, Facebook, or YouTube. We do have the YouTube channel, and it's kind of cool because you can actually see the journey as it goes and not just like popping up on the feed. So if you want to hop over there and give it a follow, that would be really appreciated. And it's a little easier to find the videos in the correct order than just finding it on like the personal Facebook or something. And if you love the videos, you can also support the journey. We got a long way back home. And it's basically just my PayPal or Venmo, and you can help buy us a meal or a truck stop shower or whatever the heck. And if not, don't worry about that. Just show up for your local music scene if you can. There's always an open mic. There's always some local music in every town, and there's a lot of great musicians out there everywhere, and we hope that you find them wherever you are. So. And we hope to see you April 1st with Clown Daddy, because there's going to be some tomfoolery to the max. Love y'all.
Jump in again?
Yeah.